वंदे गुरुपद्वंदम भक्तबिंदसमन्वितम् श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नित्यानंदसहोदितम् श्रीनंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजन समायुक्तम् बिंदावनम् मनोहर वांछाकल्पतरुवश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यः पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरं यत्कृपातमहं वन्दे परमानन्दमाधवं वृन्दावै तुलसीदेवै पियावै केशवश्च कृष्णभक्तिपदे देवी सत्त्वत्वयी नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीर संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेशे गौरी पत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरु भक्ति युक्त भक्ति प्रमोदाक्ष जगोद्वरुण दैयम् सदा परिभवग्न भविष्टदूहम् तीर्थास्पदम् शिव विरंचनुतम् सरण्यम् भीतात्तिहम् पुनतपाल भवाद्दिपूतम् वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दम् यत्पाद पल्लवनकचन्दमनि छटाय विस्फुरजित किमपि गपवधूस्वदर्शि पूर्णानुरागरस सागर सारमूर्ति साराधिकामयि कदा कृपां करोषि श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवसदि गौरभक्तबिंद श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवसदि गौर भक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे आजान लंबित भुजौ कनकावदातु संकीर्तनैकवितरौ कमलायताक्षौ विश्वाम्बरौ द्विजवरौ जुगधर्मपालौ वंदे जगत्प्रियकरौ करुणाभतारौ हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वंदितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरीनिरन्तरविभूषितवामभागं नारायणो प्रियमनंगमदापहारं वाराणसीपुरपति भज वीशनाथं वागीशजस्य वदने लक्ष्मीर्जस्य च वक्षसी यस्यास्ति हृदये संविद्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे नौते विदु स्वार्थ गोतिं हि विष्णु दूरासयाजे बहिरार्थमान अंधा यथान्धैरुपनीयमान तेयो पिशुचतान्तमुरुदां निबाध्य नौते विदु स्वार्थ गोतिं हि विष्णु दूरासयाजे बहिरार्थमान अंधा यथान्धैरुपनीयमान तेयो पिशुचतान्तमुरुदां निबाध्य
गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्रीशील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगतगुरु टोल्ड दैट पीपल स्टैंडिंग इन वन प्लेटफॉर्म इफ दे आर गोइंग टू पास रिमार्क अबाउट थिंग्स पर्टेनिंग टू अनदर प्लेटफॉर्म पीपल व्हेन गोइंग टू पास रिमार्क about another platform in which he is standing at present he is standing in this platform, so he should not pass any remark about things happening in other platform. If they are going to do so, then different kind of problem going to arise. Papa speaking, they are going to pass remark about which is out of their realization. How they can realize, how they can understand what is happening there? So they are going to pass remark. This is the situation of present society. Actually, Prahlad Maharaj speaking that in front of Hiranyakashipu, the embodiment, you know, of Kamini Kanchan, नौते विदु स्वार्थ गतिम ही विष्णु नौते विदु स्वार्थ गतिम ही विष्णु एक्चुअली दोस टू टीच एक्चुअली यू नो किंग गोइंग टू पुट क्वेश्चन दैट वेयर फ्रॉम यू गेट दिस काइंड ऑफ फ्रॉम योर गुरुदेव दिस टू गुरु वेयर फ्रॉम यू लर्न प्रहलाद महाराज स्पीकिंग नौते विदु स्वार्थ गतिम ही विष्णु It is totally out of their conception that Vishnu is the ultimate, you know, thing of our life. Vishnu is the ultimate object of our life, all Jivatma. That they don't know. Nate vidu swartha gatim hi Vishnu. They don't know even that Vishnu is the ultimate, you know, goal, should be the ultimate goal of our life. So how they can teach me? This way, नौते विदु स्वार्थ गति में विष्णु दूरा सयाजे बहिर अर्थमान Actually, they are always having material conception. They are bohiprogga chalito. Their brain, their you know everything going outside world. Shabdo sparsho rupo rasa gandho. Five kind of different, you know, ingredients of enjoyment. Prakriti Devi, the nature, Durga Devi, Maya Devi, going to decorate, opening a nice market in which all different kind of things are available. Bonded soul like to run for that always. Any kind of enjoyment they like to get from this material world. They never try to understand the kind of enjoyment you are going to expect is unstable. In Gita, many times I told before, Gita, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, jehi sansparsaja bhogaha duksha janaye evate adyantavanta kantiyo nateshu ramate vidaha. Those who are really intelligent, they never go for sensual enjoyment because some beginning and end. It is not perpetual enjoyment. It is not perpetual enjoyment. Some beginning and some end is there. So ultimately, Maya Devi going to put you in the misery of ocean of misery. So bonded soul, they are so foolish, they don't understand.
So they are always attracted by sabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. Any kind of enjoyment you mean, you can try to understand that all, you know, sabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. Our Krishna Bhagavan speaking, any tangible facilities, any kind of material things can give you enjoyment, but not permanent enjoyment, temporary, for some time. But the formula of this, you know, civilization, materials, you know, this in a present situation, you see, all around civilization, this is not actually civilization. Their formula is khao, piyo, jio. You know, enjoy yourself, that is the formula of their life. So how they can understand about that secret Tattva Bhagavat, Tattva Vigyan? And who is going to speak about that Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan? He is also blind. So there is no solution. There is no solution. Jehi samsparsa jabhoga duksha yano evate. Ultimately going to put you in the ocean of misery. Krishna Bhagavan speaking. But bonded soul always like to jump into fire. What to do? Prahlad Maharaj speaking, how they can teach me about this secret Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan? It's not possible because they themselves don't know. Their idea, their conception, their mind always going outside, searching some enjoyment, facility, lap, puja, patishta, everything. Bahi pragya chalito. Just like example I already gave yesterday, Daksha Prajapati, his mind and conception always, you know, going outside, running outside. There is no antadishti, there is no inside vision. Those who are actual sadhu, they have the inside vision. Whenever you look at any actual sadhu, actual tattvavid sadhu, Mahabhagavat, I don't know you have experience or not, I have direct experience, I know. When, and I know this kind of practical experience, you know, I have. Whenever I used to look at any, you know, Mahabhagavat, like Srila Bhakti Bhumat Puri Goswami Maharaj or Na, so many, you know, that time, but gradually now, one by one, they are going away from this material world. But that time, actually, I have, you know, I had practical experience, actually. So, I used to look at them. Immediately, I could realize that they are lost in some other world. Their conception is not running outside. Their mentality, their conception not going outside. Their antadishti. As if he is lost in somewhere. This Mahasadhu, Josuar, Mahabhagavat, you can see they are not looking outside. They are not looking out, they are always having inside vision, always. It seems they are looking outside, but not looking anything. Follow. Like Srila Gaurakishor Das Babaji Maharaj used to say at the bank of Gangaji, Ganga, and they are making one unstable kutia, bhajan kutir. And so, and actually naughty boys, there's a dangerous, you know, there's naughty boys. They used to speak all rubbish against Babaji Maharaj, Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj. Baba, sometime Babaji Maharaj looking, you know, at Ganga, those young boys, actually, naughty boys, they used to speak, oh, you are so dirty man, you are looking that those women, they are taking bath, you are looking at that. Actually, Babaji Maharaj is not looking anywhere. He is thinking, his darshan is there inside Vrindavan. They are speaking. Sometimes those naughty boys, they are going to throw stone at him. He used to speak, okay, I can go to Yashodama and speak that you are doing this kind of, you know, problem with me. You are putting me in trouble. I can speak to Yashodama. So you see the darshan. But those dirty people always think dirty way. Because they are narrow darshan. Repeatedly I am speaking many times. that if you go on hearing all philosophy, dry philosophy, no use. If you go on hearing Harikatha, that means I can expect that you are going to change your vision. Your darshan changing. You are day by day going to attain accurate darshan as it is. Now your darshan is not as it is. It's dirty darshan, narrow. With narrow, you know, darshan, you cannot see anything. So day by day I can expect on hearing Harikatha, you can develop your yatha yathatma parimijyate aso matpunna gatha sabano vidhanai. I told na many times. Yatha yathatma parimijyate aso matpunna gatha sabano vidhanai. You know, the more you can go on hearing actual Harikatha, it's one kind of medicine, you know, life-saving medicine. Surely it can change your heart if you are not kapat. Because Prabhupada often used to say, those who are kapat, those who are aparadhi, those who have done great aparad, unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, unto the lotus feet of Harinam Prabhu, though externally they are going to attain Harikatha, so many Harikatha they are hearing, but still, they cannot get, you know, mangal. Prabhupada speaking, maybe they are hearing so many Harikatha, but still, even after hearing Harikatha from a very elevated, realized soul, he is not speaking from his memory, he is speaking from heart. Prabhupada speaking, those who are great, you know, aparadhi, offenders, aparadhis, you know, those are doing aparadha unto the lotus feet of Harinam, Prabhu, Vaishnava, aparadha, anything. If they are going to hear Harikatha from a very excellent, deliberate devotee, still, they cannot get result. Because their aparadha going to make one kind of insulation, non-conductor of electricity, you know. In science we know, if I am going to put one non-conductor or insulation in between two current source, so I cannot expect current to flow, because non-conductor or insulation at all, plastic or like this PVC, so non-conductor or, you know. So this way, if somebody going to do aparadha unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan, Dham, Nam, Prabhu, then they are going to lose their consciousness. They are surely going to lose their consciousness. Their consciousness can come down to such a level that almost we can see passive state. Passive. They are hearing Harikatha, but hearing not going to strike their heart. You know, Harikatha they are hearing externally, but Harikatha cannot give any result to them. So this way, if we go on hearing Harikatha for continuously, then there is big problem. So, If I am not getting any inspiration to do bhajan, even after hearing Harikatha, even after watching a glowing, you know, example, Guru Vaishnava, those are powerful Guru Vaishnava, I am watching. Even after that, I am not feeling inspiration to do Harinam. There is some lethargy, tiredness, you know, tiredness coming, you know. In that case, you must understand there is some big aparad. So you will have to find out why you are not getting inspiration to do bhajan. That means some aparad must be there. You will have to search out, you will have to go back your memory and think, knowingly, unknowingly, you have done some mistake or not. Then if you can rectify, then you can understand. And if you go on hearing Harikatha continuously, I challenge, you know, I am sitting in Vyasasan. If your consciousness is low at present, if you go on hearing Harikatha, there is no duplicity, 100% very quickly, you can come to a very high level to understand what is what. You know, at present some suspicions, some doubts can come, and if there is any doubt in your, even after hearing Harikatha, if you cannot, you know, find any solution, immediately you will have to put question in front of Guru Vaishnava. Otherwise, if this kind of suspicion or this kind of, you know, doubts you are going to maintain throughout your life, if there is no solution, then 100%, you know, faith you cannot grow. And if you cannot grow faith, 100% faith, then you cannot come out successful. That's why in Gita, Sankshay Atma Vinashvati, those who are having septic minded, some suspicion, doubts, then in that case there is no solution. There, somehow you have to find solution by Pranipat Parivashno Seva, then you can expect consciousness to go up and up. And if your consciousness going up, then you can realize everything, who is sadhu, who is not, what is actual harikatha, what is actually, you know, material katha, all you can realize. But everything depends upon your satsanga. Everything depends upon your what kind of sangha you are doing. Maybe you are doing some satsanga, at the same time you are doing some asatsanga also. So this kind of mixing procedure is not allowed at all in pure bhajan life. And you know, in bhajan life, if you like to come out successful, you will have to do satsanga. Satsanga means you will have to leave asatsanga. Yeah? Satsanga means if you are at all going, you are interested about satsanga, then 100% I am sure that you are going to leave asatsanga. Because satsanga, asatsanga both at a time cannot run. If running, then there is duplicity inside you. Maybe you like to hear some harikatha, to memorize some darshan, to speak to some other people, to get clapping, nothing else, la puja patishta, or what can be the reason. Because satsanga means gradually you can lose your connection with asatsanga, it's quite natural. So satsanga, you should realize what do you mean by satsanga is very important thing. You know, lava matto sadhu sanga sarvasiddhi hoy, not a matter of joke. Not a matter of joke, but you are not getting. That's why yesterday I told Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, those who are interested about satsanga, they must leave evil association, asatsanga. And people, common people, they have misconception about satsanga. They think, only we can go to them, this, that. And, but for Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, main thing is that you will have to hear Harikatha from them. You will have to learn their etiquette, acharan, everything from them to apply in your life gradually to get result in your life. Otherwise, what use of satsanga? Satsanga, asatsanga, everybody doing this. Maybe asatsanga is, I was speaking all about this topics, you know, previous harikathas, in fine form, in so fine form, you cannot even imagine. Yeah, it is asatsanga. It is asatsanga. Impossible. Yes, but it is asatsanga. But you cannot realize. This kind of thing, you know. Prabhupada speaking, before attaining power in bhajan line, before attaining power, I mean, so long you are not going to get chitbal, sufficient chitbal. Kipa karo pabhu diya chitbal. Chitbal mean, you know, power. Chitbal mean aprakita power. Aprakita power you can get through Guru Vaishnava, not directly. So, Prabhupada speaking, before attaining this kind of, you know, sufficient power to cut all, you know, problem in front of you, anything, you know, dushanga bharjan, asasanga bharjan, you will have to do asasanga bharjan. And if you can realize that this is asasanga, this is satsanga, you have tremendous affinity to get satsanga. But somehow asatsanga you are facing. But if you have realization that this is, you know, consciousness going up, you realize this, oh, it's big problem. It can throw me out from bhajan. So Prabhupada speaking, before attaining purna adhikar, perfect adhikar. That's why Prabhupada often used to discuss this point. Sheshe adhikari janishtaha saguna parikirtita viparyastu dosha. is sloka, many times I discussed before. So you must understand what is satsanga, what is asasanga, how to do satsanga. Oh, very important issues. You will have to understand. This way, actually, if you can avoid asasanga from your life totally, then you can feel that power coming inside you. Knowingly, unknowingly, if you are going to do asasanga, this is a big problem. And those who are going to misguide you, cheating you, you can realize it very easily then. So first of all, you will have to open your eyes. Now you are blind, like Prahlad Maharaj speaking na, they are actually, you know, how we can expect guidance from a blind man? Andha yathandi rupaniyamanam. How I can expect guidance from a blind man? A blind man cannot move, you know, and how I can expect that he can guide me? So, Nate vidu swartha gatim hi visnum, they are not aware about their actual interest of their soul. Actual interest of their soul is bhakti, hari bhakti. But they are not aware about that. Nate vidu swartha gatim hi visnum. Dura sayaje bahirarthamani. They are, you know, they are bahiprakka chalito. They are running outside. Their, you know, mind and conception, they are going outside. Searching some lapuja puja patishta enjoyment outside. And those who are pure sadhu, their attention is always inside. Always they are antardarshi, antardrishti. If you talk with one sadhu, then you can, if you are not blind, if your eyes is by now opened, by hearing, after hearing Harikatha, then you can realize. If anyone asks, they can immediately, they can answer. Because they are actually from that world. Physically you can find they are staying in this world, but not that actually. So, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, then nate vidu sartha gatim hi visum dura sayaje dui bahirarthamani andha yathandhiru puniyamanam te api sichatantam urudam nibadhya. They are bonded, you know, urudam. You know, like, you know, a bull, if, you know, there is, you know, tight bondage and he is bound to, that bull is bound to move around according to the desire of their, you know, master. So that is the condition. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, Miche mayar vase jachya bheshe khachya habudu bhai. You know, Miche mayar vase jachya bheshe. You know, you are flowing in maya, in the stream of maya, going away towards hell. Miche mayar vase jachya bheshe khachya habudu dubu bhai. You know, this Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking this way. So, first of all, we will have to hear Harikatha gradually and we should have clear conception about Guru Tattva, Vaishnava Tattva, Acharya Tattva, because that was the first, you know, advice of Srila Prabhupada. Prabhupada always wanted to speak that you try to understand Vaishnava Tattva, Guru Tattva, Acharya Tattva, then nobody can cheat you. Because once this is done, clear to you, then all other things can be done automatically. So, actually, those who are holding the flag of Dharma, Bhagavad Dharma, we cannot believe them because they have some cheating propensity, they have some cheating, you know, they are cheating, you know, mood all the time. So, we cannot believe them because they are holding the flag, but they are corrupted inside. So, their acharan, their harikatha, if you go to get good association, in the name of good association, you are going to get a satsanga. Because satsanga is so powerful, so powerful, there is no other way. Iha jagati sajjana sangati reka bhavati bhavarnabhav tarane nauka is the only way open. Sadhu Sangha without satsanga is no way. But you are getting so much satsanga going here and there. Yesterday also I discussed about, If you are really chatur, if you are really clever, if you are cunning, not good. And if you are very clever to do which, Jijan Krishna Bhaje Sihai Bado Chatur. Those who are doing Hari Bhajan, they are very clever. Clever means how to engage in Hari Bhajan, how to avoid material connection. They are very clever. They know it. Very clever. They know this formula, how to avoid asasanga, get engaged in Hari Bhajan continuously. That the technique, they always, you know, have clear idea about that. You know, and many times I told before, Prabhupada speaking, Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj speaking to Bimala Prasad, this quotation, and we heard from Prabhupada speaking. My Guru Padmasambhava sometimes used to speak, Amar Prabhu, oh my Prabhu, you know, try to get engaged in Hari Bhajan, Hari Nam. Those who are, you know, outside people, try to, you know, avoid them, you know, this way, you know, Gaur Kishore Babaji used to give advice to him. So actually, it is not possible for a bonded soul, maybe externally elected. So what? Thousands of such cases, you can come, I can show you. Oh, dangerous condition. So that is not a big issue. But point is that bonded soul cannot act as acharya. It is not possible. Whereas I already told yesterday that whereas, you know, these common people, they are going to follow an idealism, a very fine, high idealism. At present situation is that if one sadhu is having high, big idealism, nice, still people, they are going to ignore because they are doing, already have done aparad, they are not growing consciousness, they cannot understand what they are doing. More and more aparad they are going to do. So, actually, Krishna not going to take your responsibility. Krishna not going to take your responsibility. If you are going to think about Krishna continuously, all the time, non-stop, why? Why actually Krishna cannot take your responsibility? Why Krishna cannot take responsibility of common people, bonded soul? Because they are not going to think about do bhajan continuously. Maybe they are doing bhajan, so-called devotees. Maybe for half an hour, for 2 hours, after that they are again engaged in material conception, material things. So this is a specific idea Prabhupada wanted to speak. That how you understand that he is Sadguru? In the life of, you know, of a Sadguru, you cannot find any time that they are engaged in material things. Prabhupada speaking, the clear indication of a Sadguru, the clear indication of a Sadguru is their Ananya Bhajan, their unique bhajan. 24 hours they are engaged in bhajan. Clear indication, clear symptom of a Sadguru is their unique Hari Bhajan, Hari Seva, non-stop Hari Seva. That's why Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking in Gita, Ananas Chintayantu Mang Ji Yana Parjubasati, Tesam Nittavi Yuktanam Yogokhyamam Bahami Bahamyam. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, those who are going to get in touch with me continuously, Ananas Chintayantu, no other conception there. Not that for half an hour they are, you know, engaged in some material thing, again they are, no, not that. So Ananya Chintayanto Mang Ji Yana Parjupasa Pari Upasati. you know, continuously, non-stop, they are going to do my bhajan, thinking about me. Many times Bhagavan Sri Krishna is speaking, but common people, they are so foolish, they are going to express some doubt. When Krishna is speaking, you know, mad jaji mang amaskuru, you know, you worship me, you pay dandavat to me, oh, useless, and everybody speaking, self-interest, you know. Mad jaji mang namaskuru, when Krishna is speaking, then everybody going to material people, they are going to express doubts. So anyway, if you are going to elect one bonded soul as an acharya, you know, bonded soul, if they are going to act as an acharya, you can very easily understand by their activities. Very easily, if you are blind, that you cannot understand. And they can show some, you know, extraordinary things, you know. They can show something extraordinary things, which is not, you know, in, you know, parampara, dhara. I can speak immediately now, I can go on speaking. How you can understand that this sadhu is perfect, you know, eternal acharyaship. Eternal acharyaship is totally expressed in him, manifested in inside him. So, eternal acharyaship manifested in him, how you can know? If you can find, you can see that total, you know, Sauta Pantha is totally intact, flowing through this acharya. Sauta Pantha, you know, Amnai Dhara, is totally intact way flowing to this acharya. No acting. Arre Maharaj, acting can be done 2 or 3 days or 7 days, maybe seven, say maybe 1 month, 2 months, 6 months. After that, my naked picture can be open before you. So acting is not bhajan. So Prabhupada used to speak, phalena phalakaranam animiyate. And a perfect sadhu never going to fear anything. He is fearless. There is a symptom. He never fear to speak about that absolute truth. Because he has no desire for la puja patisha. He is less interested. That's why he has a right to speak about that. So, not that everybody can speak about that absolute truth. Absolute truth cannot come. Absolute truth, the flow of absolute truth, Amnai Dara, can come and dance on the tongue of a pure sadhu. Not everywhere. You cannot expect. That's why many times before, you forget actually. You know, Jivha maru prangane si chaitanya dayanidhe tavalasad lila sudha sarduni. This slok. Now I am not speaking complete slok. Someday I can discuss again, many times before. Kishnat kirtana gana natana kala patho jani bhajita sad bhakta avalihamsa chakra madupo seni bihar aspadam karna nandi kaladhanir bahutume jivha maru prangane si chaitanya dayani dheta valasad Lila Sudha Swarduni. You can remember. A pure sadhu, his tongue is always sweet. His tongue is so sweet, always he's speaking Harikatha. Continuous. Maybe he is walking down the street, but still Harikatha going inside his heart. Non-stop connection. You cannot believe. I would request you to come up to that level, then you can realize, hey, really am I. I have practical experience. Night time, 2 o'clock, I have seen Guru Maharaj is sleeping externally, but tongue dancing, I have seen. Tongue dancing, whole night. I was surprised to see. You know, I was every moment, I know, I was learning I was learning so many things, every moment from Guru Pad Padma. So, material people, if they are going to act as an acharya, like Sando and Marka, they are busy with, you know, their final account. Their final account, they are busy with their, you know, financial matters, final account, what debit and credit, this is. But you can search the life of a pure devotee, they are less interested about that. They are very sure you know, about that if I can keep myself in parampara line, then Gauriamat can automatically run. I need not, I cannot run a Gauriamat. It is one kind of audacity. I cannot run a Gauriamat. Gauriamat can automatically gonna go. Only I will have to do one thing, that I will have to stay and get established in Bhakti Vinod Dhara. That I will have to do, nothing else. Only I will have to get established in Bhakti Vinod Dhara. If I find in the society some avakti vinod dhara, I will have to avoid it. Material association, material things, always, you know, anukul, anukulyasya sankalpa, pratikulya vivarjanam. So how you can understand? If you find continuous flow of amnai dhara, if you can find continuous flow of amnai dhara, amnai means, you know, sauta parampara going on through him, intact way. Intact way, you cannot find even a single mistake of Siddhanta in their life. Maybe pronounce it due to the physical and unfitness, some, you know. That's why I told them many times that whenever I wanted to speak this thing, never try to misunderstand me that if any kind of defect you find, the physical defects, you know, stammering, this, that. So that doesn't mean you will have to think he is not Vaishnava. Not that. You know, follow. You know, there can be some physical defects, is that some, you know, habit, some, you know. But that doesn't mean he is not Vaishnava. That's why Rupa Goswami Pad always wanted to give warning before us. Drishtvai sabhava janitair vapuscha dosair na prakatitvam iha bhakta janishya pashyet. Gangnam basham na khalu budbudha phena pankai brahma dabattam apagachyate nida dharmai. Why Pundarik Vidyanidhi used to go night time to see, take darshan of Ganga? Because daytime Pundarik Vidyanidhi used to avoid daytime. Why? But daytime, if going to pay dandavad, he can develop some wrong conception. Oh, so dirty things, you know, Ganga, so many dirty things are floating in Ganga. So Pundarik Vidyanidhi used to pay dandavat Ganga ji, Ganga Mata, night time, not daytime. And one unique thing, we know it very sure that whenever we are going to do archan, before that one drop of water is not allowed. We cannot take any drop of water. Even it is the rules, before you are entering into kitchen to cook for Supreme Lord, I am not going to impose, I am not going to put pressure on you. This is the usual system in pure Vaishnava society. You cannot do it, you can feel, very shortly you can feel sick. But, as, you know, because if you go to cook, if you are going to enter into kitchen of Supreme Lord, Mahasan, it is called in Sanskrit, you will have to avoid, you will have to avoid taking any food or water. If you take, then you cannot cook. It's very dangerous actually. Now at present situation changing, people, they are feeling so weak. So how we can put pressure on them, this is not the rules. But actually, Pundarik Vidyanidhi used to drink a lot of water before sitting for archan. So now you are going to find fault with, hey, so bad habit, is going to drink water before archan, whereas it is completely, you know, prohibited. Are you can put your prohibition, you know, it is prohibited, but your rules and regulation is there with you. But Pundarik Vidyanidhi is, you know, above all rules and regulation. So Pundarik Vidyanidhi taking, drinking water before sitting into for archan, it's the only reason, this is the conception of Pundarik Vidyanidhi, that if we can drink water, Ganga water, then I can purify myself, I can get enough purity to sit for archan. Anyway, without purifying your body, bhuta shuddhi, it is called archan, in archan procedure it is called bhuta shuddhi, bhuta shuddhi. That's why Mahaprabhu used to give us this mantra. Nahang vipra na cha narpati na pivishya na sudra nahang varani na cha gyapatir na yud. This is a mantra, is called bhuta shuddhi in Gauriya line. But You know, other mantras are there, in Archan Paddhati actually. You know, Deva Bhutva Deva Marchayat. It is written in Archan Paddhati. If you cannot purify yourself, how you can sit for Archan? If you are not pure, then how? If you are not pure, then how you can do Archan? It's not possible for you to sit for Archan. It's not possible. So Deva Bhutva Deva Marchayat. Before doing sitting for Archan, you will have to purify yourself. So now you will have to think. In the morning time, maybe 3:30, 3 o'clock, or maybe 4 o'clock. So much strict restriction you cannot follow. So after getting out, you have to take, purify yourself and sit in a pure asana to do bhajan, everything, archan, everything you have to do. So now, actually, common people, they cannot follow this kind of rules and regulation, strict regulation, big problem. So, bonded soul when acting as acharya. Now I am going to speak a series of harikatha, countless harikatha. By the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, or your mercy also. So you will have to remember it, you will have to digest it, you will have to follow this. Then 100%, I am sure 100%, then nobody can cheat you. All symptoms, first of all, there should not be any duplicity. If you are fair and above board, a very clean heart, then you can realize everything. Baldev, Baldaji Maharaj going to open your eyes, you can see everything, what is what. So, what is the symptom of a pure acharya? That continuous flow, continuous flow of Bhaktivinoda Dhara, you can discover in his life. Continuous flow of Sautapantha. Sautapantha, you can find Amnai Dhara. So now I am interested to discuss about the Amnai Dhara so that you can understand. So that you have no possibility to misunderstand me. So you can remember yesterday I told, whereas prasadam, mahaprasadam can easily make me free from material torture, but I am not getting free. Why? Yesterday I was speaking, Uddhavji Maharaj speaking to in front of Prabhu, Bhagavan. Baba, dekho, Prabhu, tayopabhukto sragandho basa alankara charchitaha uchishto bhojino dasaha stabomayam jaye mahi. It is 100% sure that Prabhu, we are going to use all your prasadam. Tayopa bhukto. Srak mean garland, gandhavasa, gandho, scent, essence, chandan, adi, everything, vaso, your clothes, alankar, ornaments, everything, your uchishta prasadam, everything. So Uddhavji Maharaj shouting in joy, with joy. Prabhu, tayopabhukto sragandho vaso alankar charchitaha uchishta bhojino dasahastabo mayam jayemahi. No doubt. But I am not getting free. So now you will have to go back to this conception. Dharana. Is there any mistake? Is it at all prasadam? I am following all rules and regulation. I am maintaining purity, everything or not? Or at all, if it is prasadam, why not going to give me facility to cut maya? So automatically this kind of conception can come. This kind of symptom I am going to speak you, so that you can realize the symptom of a pure sadhu. Nobody can cheat you, I am guarantee, I am sure. All different, from different angle I am going to point you out. So, you should understand this. So, those who are going to do enough Guru Vaishnava Seva in their life, enough to get full power of realization, that's mean self-manifested Achajyosip can come in front of you. Self-manifested. Automatically, through pure Guru Vaishnav Seva, through pure Guru Vaishnav Seva, through pure Guru Vaishnav Seva, surely they are going to get power. And Guru Seva, pure Guru Seva, without any self-interest, a smell of self-interest should not be there. Automatically, the, you know, it can manifest. You know, eternal acharyaship can get manifested in his life. So, we must remember what Buddha Prabhu is saying, any kind of prasadam pure we are going to take, going to give us extraordinary facilities. Because we know, in Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, Jagadananda Pandit also speaking in his, you know, Prem Vivartha, Bhaktava says, I mean the Uchishta Prasadam of Bhakta, water was of Vaishnava and the dust particle of a pure, from the lotus feet of a pure Vaishnava, all thin are the, you know, very high, powerful medicine in the way of our bhajan. I can discuss some advice by Ramanujacharya. Ramanujacharya speaking, practically I feel in my life. Ramanujacharya giving it, I can discuss, even I can publish also. Because it is in line with, you know, all devotees, they can learn so many things. Ramanujacharya speaking, by chance you are going to, by chance, somehow, if you are going to, you know, discuss something or talk with some pasanda, heartless people, those who are enough Vaishnava para they have done. In that case, immediately we will have to, you know, take bath in Ganga, Kaveri, or you immediately will have to mental bath also. Immediately we will have to take the water wash of Vaishnava. Water wash, you know, padadhauta jal. Immediately to purify yourself. Otherwise, that day you can find black day. In my life, that day you can remember, Nishinga Chaturthi day I couldn't speak. 100%. Now I was thinking, I was crying. What can be the reason? Oh, then, oh my God. I am speaking, I am giving lecture to others, but I forget. Oh, this is a mistake. Then again, I, you know, give back whatever thing he brought. I pay against pranami. I told to my Torun Prabhu, you pay him 1,000 rupees pranami immediately. And whatever he bring, immediately you distribute outside. Don't use it here. And for as an expiation, I was bound to take bath. Though I love from inside, I like to change their life, but what to do? You know, I was bound to do it purified, then I started Harikatha. So Ramanujacharya speaking, if you are going to make some mistake, the great Vaishnava Prati here, if you are going to talk with them, immediately you have to take, you know, medicine. I mean, medicine means it is dangerous, more dangerous than coronavirus. You'll have to take the Charanamrita of Vaishnava immediately. You know, try to, you know, take bath in Ganga, hear the, you know, Gomata, Gomutra, urine of Gomata, cow dung, immediately. Otherwise, you can, you know, big problem can be there, you know. So you see, Tayopo Bhukto Sraggandho Vasalankara Charchitaha Uchishto Bhojino Dasahastavo Mayam Jai Mahi is a definite, you know, affirmative. Definite, I am going to cut Maya Prabhu. What problem? But it should be prasadam, and your mood should be very clean to before accepting prasadam. Prasado seva kurite hayo shakalo pro pancho jayo. You have to remember this point. Now, actually, those who are pure Vaishnav, those who are Paramahansa, everywhere they are going to see their Ishtadev. They are going to look Ishtadev. They are not watching any beautiful girl, beautiful woman, nothing. Believe me, you cannot believe, I know. You cannot believe because you cannot reach up to that far stage. A Paramahansa Vaishnav always watching their Ishtadev everywhere. Everywhere. That's why they are so powerful. Ishtadev. Always and everywhere they are Ishtadev. And also in Gita, I like to touch. You know, and also from Bhagavat I can speak, because after clearing this I can go to Amnai Dara, how to protect, who is the protector, what is the advice given by Bhaktivinoda, all I can discuss, all I cannot forget, you know, to discuss it. You know, in Srimad Bhagavaji Mahapuran, it is, you know, we already know the Adyai Gyan Tattva. You know this term, you are, you know, habituated to hear this term. Badandi tat tatta vidam stattam jad jnanam adyam brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavan iti sabdati. This Adyai Gyan Tattva, not a matter of joke. Not a matter of joke. Those who are pure Vaishnav, those who are going to rectify others, those who are going to deliver bonded soul, they all are established in Adyai Gyan Tattva. Many times I told before, inside Adyai Gyan Tattva there is countless diversity. Regarding Jiva Tattva, I can speak in details that about Jiva Tattva. Why different kind of Jivatma coming? Oh, with different sanskar. What is the reason? You know. So also, you know, those who are not totally established in Adyai Gyan Tattva, if they go outside, they can find some beautiful house, beautiful lady, wife of somebody. This way they can get deviated from the track of Bhagavad Bhajan. So it is not possible for them to go outside for preaching. They will have to preach in front of themselves. They will have to preach in front of themselves first. If they are successful to preach in front of themselves, it means to preach in front of themselves mean, what do you mean? You know what I mean to say? If they are totally successful, you know, to preach in front of themselves, then no problem. What does it mean? It means what advice is going to speak to others, that advice is already tested in his life, already applied. You know, first stage, second stage, and third stage of corona vaccine going on. But how many round of tests, you know, should be there in your life? You can go mad. You know, we are actually playing. We are like small children. They are playing with toys. We are playing with japamala, this, that. You know, they don't know what is the gravity. What is the gravity? What is the excellency of bhajan, Hari bhajan? If you can get the taste of Hari bhajan, if somebody is going to cut your throat, still you cannot leave Hari bhajan. That's why I told, he is sadhu who is not going to leave the absolute truth in front of death. Prahlad Maharaj not going to leave that absolute truth in front of death. Dhruva Maharaj not going to leave his, you know, that absolute truth in front of death. Jarabharaji Maharaj not going to leave the absolute truth in front of that, in front of death. They are sadhu. But those who are going to change their body color and conception like chameleon, how I can say? Prabhupada used to joke and speak, jokhon jedike hawa boy. You know, jokhon je, Prabhupada used to joke with this point. Those who are going to, Bhaman Goswami Maharaj also used to speak in a very joking way. We are watching the wind, like political, you know, field. Those who are watching, now wind is there, now this way, so I must join this party. And now after two years, no, it's bad conception, then they are going to leave that party, going to join another party who is having some prosperity and a prospect in a coming election. This is the situation of our bhajan life. It's just like political party at present. Very dirty situation. So, why I am going to speak, if he is successful, you know, when he is going to preach in front of himself. You know, Prabhupada speaking, he will have to preach in front of himself. Without that, he should not go outside for preaching. He can make some all rubbish, you know, problem can happen. Because in the house of those, you know, householders, there are beautiful girls, wives are there, there are so many appliances can be there. Those material, you know, idiot people going for preaching in the base of red cloth, yellow cloth, you know, green cloth, white cloth. they are going to make some dirty result. So how people can respect us if they cannot find any idealism? You know, even their situation is, you know, more bad than those, you know, those who are believing in ethical character in the material world. At least therefore they are maintaining their ethical character, you know, in material world. But they are not going to think about character, situation, environment, nothing. Only I like to make profit. And you know, otherwise, why should I serve Gurudev if there is no profit? Really so? If Gurudev is not going to make me acharya, why should I serve? What is my interest? Really so. We want to, even after Gurudev gone, we like to express ourselves as a pension holder. Well, I have done seva of Gurudev for 10 years. Now I am a stipend holder or pension holder. This is our situation. But what I mean to say, you will have to preach in front of yourself before going for preaching. What does it mean? It means, upadesham karati eva na pariksham karati ya aparikshaam upadeshtam yad yagad nasaya tad bhavet. You are going to give advice, that preacher are going to give advice to other people, but those advice he is giving, not at all tested in his own life. That is going to ruin the whole world. Upadesham karati eva, na pariksham karati ya. Aparikshaam upadeshtam yad, yagad nasaya tad bhavet, is going to ruin the whole world. Gradually, it's like multiple way reaction, you know, multiple way of reaction, like coronavirus. Now two people, now four, you know, 16, these are multiple way, increasing rate, you know. There's a horrible condition. Nobody interested to follow, you know, South Pantha, you know, the track shown by Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Vishwa Vaishnava, all acting, you know, like acting. So now, by now you are sure what I mean to say. Advaigan Tattva, one pure sadhu is always totally established in Advaigan Tattva. Be sure. He is very happy to see the diversity. He is very happy to see the diversity, but inside his heart always there that it is Advaigan Tattva. But still there is diversity shown by Krishna. So, countless diversity there. But inside his, you know, his heart, he can realize that within this, you know, great diversity, infinity diversity, surely there is, you know, Advaigan Tattva, unity. Unity in diversity and diversity in unity. Both they can realize. One example, another example I can give. So from Srimad Bhagavad Gita, you can remember one slok from Gita, 4th chapter, 24th slok, you know, there is Brahmarpanam Brahma Havir Brahmagano Brahmana Hutam Brahmaivatena Gantabhyam Brahma Karma Samadhina. You can remember, yesterday also I was bound to discuss this point. Sriyano Dibhamaya Yogyad Gyan Yogyam Parantapaha Sarvana Karavana Khilam Partho Gyane Parishamapati. This I discussed yesterday. This is also from 4th chapter, 33 sloka. And we will have to complete because, you know, all devotees, they are giving order to me to complete Gita. But how I can complete? I am not getting any time. Better I can complete Gita in, you know, this live telecast is good. Because otherwise I cannot get time. This way I can go on Gita and on. Directly I can speak about that, you know, about other topics in Purushottam Vrata, Kartik Vrata. So I am thinking what to do. You know, I cannot complete because time not permitting me what to do. I am, you know, this is very sorry. I beg for pardon for that. I cannot complete for long time over. I am not going to, how to do, what to do, you know. But anyway, you must remember this sloka, Brahmarpanam Brahma Havir Brahmaganau Brahmanahutam Brahmaivatena Gantabhyam Brahma Karma Samadhina. In the principle of seeing Brahma everywhere, in the form of, you know, where is it? Brahmarpanam, what I am going to offer into, you know, ghee, clarified butter, and the holder, I mean the spoon with which I am going, who is giving, and the fire it himself, who is going to arrange everything, Brahma. So, Brahmarpanam Brahma Havir Brahmagno, Brahmagno, Brahmanahutam, Brahmagno mean Brahma Agni in Brahma Agni, Brahma Agni Te, Brahmagno. So, Brahmarpanam Brahma Havir Brahmagno, Brahmanahutam, Brahmaivatena Gantabhyam, Brahma Karma Samadhina. The principle of seeing Brahma everywhere, in the form of there's a Hota, Udgata, and the ghee clarified butter, you are going to, you know, ladle, everything, you know, Brahma. Again, oblation, but you are going to Brahma, is the fire, everything, all there, here Brahma. If you can realize this, it's very good realization. Then there is no problem. I am not speaking like Mayadevi, Mayavadi. You know, Brahma means Parabrahma, Paratpara, Khileshwar Brahma. I am not speaking about impersonal Brahma. You know. So now I can come to the main conception where I wanted to speak. If you are slightly tilted from this, your, you know, equipoised position, you cannot keep balance now. You are attracted by Maya. Then you are going to lose your position. You cannot act as Acharya. Not a matter of joke, man, come on. It's a not a matter of joke. Whereas Krishna speaking, Acharya, try to understand, I myself is Acharya. Yesterday also I told, when Krishna appeared in front of me as an advisor, absolute advisor, then is Guru. So, Acharya man bijanyat na bamannet karhichit na marto buddhya suyeto sarva deva mayo guru. Sarva deva mayo guru, all everything. Sarva deva, everything is there. You know, guru is not a matter of joke. So, we are going to make politics with, you know, like a, you know, political party. This group, that group. I can explain more clearly. In the idealism, in the life, you know, in the etiquette, in the bhajan life of unperfect acharya, there cannot be any symptom of jivhingsa. Jivhingsa, you know, jivhingsa, envious, and you know, jivhingsa. It is only Gauriya Math, Prabhupada wanted to explain this way. Other people, they don't know. They think physical assault, you know, taking away something from somebody, beating him, killing him, is called jivhingsa. Only and only Gauriya Acharya Bharya Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, he was bound to explain this way. So accuracy, you know, Prabhupada used to explain that if I am not going to speak about that absolute truth, whereas I know they are running wrong way. Whereas I know it clearly that they are blind, they are running wrong way. I have my opportunity to guide them properly. If they are going to avoid me, if they are going to throw me, then no problem. But if I find that they are going to accept my advice, I will have to speak that you are running wrong way. You have to rectify, this is not good. This is the utility of Mathavas. This is the topmost facility of Mathavasi Jivam. Guru Padmadma used to speak, they are not staying in Math. Baba, they are not staying in Math, they are staying in Komath. Komath. Mathavas, the life of a Mathavasi Jivan, life of a Mathavasi, you know, devotee is very pure. But who is going to set rules and regulations all broken? So you see, you know, there is big problem. So All rules and regulations you will have to follow. All harikatha you will have to. Matavasi jivan means you will have to rectify yourself every fraction of second. But you have taken resolution. I am brahmachari. Who are you to speak? Go out of my temple. In my life, Maharaj, I am sitting in Vyasasana. There is the only tragedy happened in my whole life. Nothing else. Nobody going to speak any rubbish against me. Only they are stinging. He is very strict. I cannot allow, we cannot allow this thing. It is one kind of comedy in my life, not tragedy. You can think that way. You know, everywhere, even in Vrindavan, any mat I speak, they feel trouble. Because I am speaking about absolute truth, Prabhupada. Then it's less interested. They say you should make some reconciliation. You have no adjustment power. Really so. I have no adjustment power. That's why I am a fallen soul. That's why I am speaking Harikatha. No adjustment power means if you put this kind of allegation against any Vaishnava, then this means you are going to speak he is not at all Vaishnava. He is a fallen soul. To speak this thing that he has no adjustment with anybody, it is equal to speaking that he is not Vaishnava. So this is the situation at present, what to do. I am very interested and to project all, you know, I never like to do any jivhingsa with you. Maybe you can, and for the time being you can hate me, you can become very angry against me. But still, I am not going to conceal, I am not going to hide any point, you know. So in the life of a pure acharya, there cannot be any single instance of jiva hinsa, cannot be there. Now you understand, everywhere a pure Vaishnava can see his Ishtadev everywhere. That is the very, very vital symptom. Mahaprabhu, when in front of Mahaprabhu, Ramananda speaking, Prabhu, what happens? Just now I see you are, you know, Gaur. Now I find Radha Govinda embracing each other. Now I again find Gaur. What is this? You try to clarify it. Prabhu smiling and speaking, actually it is point is that you are Mahabhagavat. Wherever you look, you can find your, don't try to hide, Prabhu. Please speak out, Prabhu, what is the, you know, secrecy. Then Ramananda putting pressure again and again on, you know, on Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu, ultimately, Mahaprabhu was bound to confess, please don't speak to you, because I am mad, you are also mad. We both are, you know, mad. Don't speak. Tumi batul, amyo batul. Don't speak it to anybody. Actually, Rasaraj, Mahabhav, all same. Mahabhav, all same, actually. Don't speak to anybody. Nobody can believe. They can laugh at me. And Tulsidas ji also speaking very nice way. Siya Ram mai sab jag jani karhu panam juri jug pani. Siya Ram mai sab jag jani karhu pranam juri jug pani. This is the darshan of Paramahansa. Tulsidas ji is speaking. He can see Shiaram everywhere. Ishtadev. And if I cannot see Gaurhari, I am sitting in Vyasasana, I am not speaking lie. Whenever in the morning time after Annik, when I am going to worship all Guru Varga, this, that, everything, all secrecy of bhajan. But when I am going to worship Prabhupada, I am sitting in Vyasasana. 100%. When I am going to Prabhupada, worship Prabhupada, every time I am making confusion. Sometimes I see Gauranga sitting, sometimes I see Prabhupada. Sometimes I see Gauranga, what is this? Sometimes I see Prabhupada sitting, sometimes Gauranga. This confusion. It is not confusion, it is true. It is 100% true. Gauranga coming in the form of Prabhupada. It is the exact Siddhanta. So always try to understand this point. I can speak in details. So jivhingsa mean I am, if for against whole sampradaya, I am going to make mistake. You know, I am going to do aparadh, you know, in front of my sampradaya, in front of my Gaudiya sampradaya. If I cannot speak about their absolute truth, I would be heavily punished for la puja patishtha and speaking all sweet word to you. I am not speaking about their absolute truth to earn some name and fame. I am very sweet Vaishnav, very nice Vaishnav. I am not going to speak about their absolute truth. I am going to cheat you. Then whole sampradaya now in problem. Everybody like to follow their fanciful attitude mode, like mad, crazy mad. You know, now I can go on discussing about this is jivhinsa. What kind of jivhinsa? If I cannot guide you properly, and you allow me, it is your highness. It is your highness. It is your highness, I speak you clearly. I have no quality. It is your highness that you, Guru Vaishnav, allow me to sit in Vyasasana. I am a dog of Guru Vaishnav. So I will have to remember, I should not cheat you. I should not do anything which can put you all in danger. It's a question of survival. I will have to show the exact way. I'll have to follow the exact way. Otherwise, I would be heavily punished. You know, Krishna cannot excuse me. If I am not going to speak about that absolute way, standing on absolute platform, then Krishna cannot excuse me. Krishna can give me heavy punishment. Maybe I am not going to enjoy popularity. Also, I am less interested to enjoy popularity. I cannot expect thousands of people to hear this. Still, they can hear, they cannot hear. They can become angry against me. So, this way I can explain that in the life of a pure acharya, there is no topics, I mean, dharma, artho, kam, moksha. There is no topics, no trace, no smell. Dharma, artho, kam, moksha. Dharma, artho, kam, moksha. Dharma means general dharma. Body dharma, samaj dharma, social dharma, bodily dharma, mental dharma, or so-called dharma, those are common people. You know, Kesava Goswami used to laugh at those, you know, material people. See, you are so foolish. You know, when they have no conception about nitya dharma, they have no conception, clear conception about nitya dharma. Nitya dharma, what do they mean? They nitya naimittik dharma, they think daily ritualistic activities they are doing, this is called nitya dharma. They have no conception about the actual nitya. Nitya means eternal. Sanatan, sadatanoti iti sanatana. But they have no idea. All people, most of the people, you know, they have idea, nitya means, oh, nitya puja, nitya anning, nitya snan. They say nitya, but they have no idea about nitya means eternal. Or eternal. They have no conception about this. So this way we are in a big problem happening all around. So you can understand the symptom of a pure Vaishnava. Now, actually Prabhupada speaking, Guru Varga Bhaktivinoda Thakur also speaking, the only duty, next 11th on case I can speak, I cannot find any end of my Harikatha. I cannot understand, there's so much branches coming. One by one. I think if I cannot understand, they can misunderstand me. And then at the same time, I don't know what will happen. So from different angle, I like to discuss this vital point. Prabhupada and his unique acharyaship. Also, what he wanted to speak about eternal acharyaship. Why Prabhupada wanted to speak that eternal acharyaship can get manifested in front of us if we are sincere. Because Baldaji Maharaj is going to arrange it very, very, very and clearly. Baldaji Maharaj is so merciful. Even I can say, if I depend upon Krishna, Krishna can cheat me. But Baldaji Maharaj cannot cheat me. Baldaji Maharaj is so merciful that Balaji Maharaj can never cheat me. You know, I myself is the example. You know, Guru Maharaj giving me instruction. You know, some devotee is not sannyasi, nothing. He is giving instruction. And Prabhu, everybody gone, you start worshipping Dauji in Dauji Mandir. All, they are thief. They steal something and go from temple. I was, you know, shocked to see. Cut almari, this, that. They are now holding big post. This is the situation. You know. Now actually, I was shocked. Then phone coming from Mayapur. At that time I was in Vrindavan. They are speaking, Prabhu. I say, nobody there to do archan. Okay, you start archan. I say, I am not going to follow you. I can follow Guru Pad Padma. If Guru Maharaj is going to speak me to start archan, then I can do. But actually, specially, I never do archan of Dauji Maharaj previously, long ago, I am speaking. Then give information someday that a phone coming and I find the voice of Guru Maharaj. I was dancing. Baba, you can worship Dauji. You can find the result. Baba, Guru Maharaj, I don't know the mantra through which I can say you. I can speak with the mantra. You can go on doing archan. You can get the result. I see you. Okay, Guru Maharaj. From then, I took resolution to do worship of Dauji Maharaj. Guru Maharaj gave me the mantra. Still today, after Anniga, I am doing this mantra, archan, all Dauji, everything, every day. Non-stop. You know. Then I see, really so. Dauji Maharaj is so merciful, Baba. Oh-ho, can give everything, what not? And as, you know, this life, previous life I cannot say, this life also, my starting bhajan, this, and also, I guess I get some indication. I don't like to speak that, very secret. Anyway, so, Prabhupada used to speak, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to speak the same thing. The only duty of an acharya is to give full protection to Siddhanta Bani, Amnai Bani. It is the only duty of an acharya. You can find the symptom. The only duty of an acharya is to give full protection to Siddhanta Bani. Because we can never give protection to Siddhanta Bani. Hey, we can never protect our sampradaya. Now is the situation. You know, this kind of situation prevailing all around the world. We cannot give full protection to the, you know, our sampradaya. Because sampradaya vaibhav, the great affluences of sampradaya is the bani vaibhav. If I am not ready to give full protection, what Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking, I can go on speaking repeatedly, clearly, all. Even I can speak from where I got, from Sajjantasani, here, there, where, everything I can clearly I can speak in front of you. About Sadhu Sangha also I can discuss, but now today it is my duty to touch this point so that I can clarify this point that Amnai Bani, Amnai Bani Sauta Parampara, Shauta Bani can never protect our sampradaya. We can never protect our sampradaya if we fail to give full protection to Siddhanta Bani. Because the main property is that. Through the if you like to kick out Vaishnava like Vidurji Maharaj, in my life so many things happen. I am in Vyasasan. Many times. Whenever I speak about Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda, I don't like to speak the name of that mount. Anywhere. Even I got the scope to speak in Chaitanya Math. Nobody got this kind of hope. Nobody. To speak about their spiritual truth. They are also everywhere problem. They cannot digest. They like to make me out of math. Okay. But be sure, I am staying in Chaitanya Math. I am staying in Chaitanya Math. I am staying in Chaitanya Math. In fine form. You cannot prove that I am not staying in Chaitanya Math. I am staying in Chaitanya Math. Externally, they are material people. They can deserve it. It is our Math. You go out. Okay, I can go out. I have no Math. you know, there is a situation, you know. So this way actually, to give full protection to Chaitanya Vani, Shai Siddhanta Vani, Amnaya Vani, Shauta Pantha, is the main procedure. Is the main duty of an acharya is to give full protection to Siddhanta Vani, Amnaya Vani. If you are failure to give protection to Siddhanta Vani, Amnaya Vani, then you are not at all, I cannot confess. You can make a big group, you can go against me, you can file a case against me, still I am not going to change my decision. I can never confess that you are acharya. But if I find that you are following all Amnaya Pantha, all in toto in your life, I can find all, you know, in applied form, all the, you know, examples, I can see all the symptoms, then I. Our Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you know, explaining this, you know, this Amnaya Dhara. What do you mean by Amnaya Dhara? Bhaktivinoda Thakur explaining, you know, so many books written by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I don't know whole, so many books, countless books written by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. You know, even we don't know the name of that book. We have no familiar with that book. I don't know when he wrote, when, where it is, you know, this big problem actually, you know. So, Amnaya, Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to explain this. What do you mean by Amnaya? Bhaktivinoda Thakur himself. I am just reading Bhaktivinoda Thakur what writing. I am not going to make any explanation. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, Amnaya srutayah sakshat brahmo, sakshat brahmo vidyeti vishruta. Guru parampara prapta vishwa kartur hi brahmanah. Vishwakarta, I mean the first, you know, man, Brahma, from there, he was taught by Krishna. He got, you know, yes, that day I was also speaking, na, you know, Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan coming from Krishna and Amnaya Parampara, gradually it is flowing, gradually, one by one, it is flowing through Parampara line. And also yesterday I was bound to explain this thing. Evam prakriti vaichitrat vidyante matayo ninam paramparjena kesanchit pasanna matayo apare. I told you yesterday. This way, due to the diversity of human nature, automatically there was diversity, sin in their opinion, vichar. Some started following the principle shown by previous Guru Parampara, this is called Amnaya Vani. Whereas some others, they started exhibiting or following or propagating heretic opinion, vichar, I mean pasanda vichar. This way they started doing. You know, also we know, is there, you know, this Bhagavad Dharma Tattva Vigyan is coming through Parampara, very nice way, through Parampara is coming to us. And if we are going to break the flow of that Parampara, then we cannot expect intact thing to come. You know, we cannot expect. Because yesterday I already told, Idam Bhagavatam Nama Janame Bhagavato Ditam, Brahma speaking himself is coming, Parampara Dhara. If there is breakage of Parampara, then there is big problem. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, you know, Ya Amnayaha Srutayaho Shakshat Brahma Vidyeti Vishrutaha Guru Parampara Prapta Vishwa Karturhi Brahmana. Brahma Vishwa Karta, from there, through Guru Parampara, intact knowledge, Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, if coming to us, then we can accept this. If there is breakage, out of our cheap sentiment, Maharaj, what to do? He was elected Acharya, that, what do you mean? What do you mean by that? It is a cheap sentiment. There can be problem. Bonded soul anytime can make mistake. Bonded soul can anytime. When self self Acharya Siva, eternal Acharya Siva expressed, then we cannot expect any kind of fault. Next day, I like to discuss. Every day I am speaking next day, but I cannot discuss, no time. Brahmo, Pramat, Vipralipsa, Karna, Pratap, those are the defects usually staying in bonded soul. We cannot expect this kind of defects to come in the life of a pure Guru Vaishnava. But that doesn't mean bodily defects, some disease. This is one kind of, they are separate. I can discuss in details. So you see, and also, in Mundak Upanishad, Guru Maharaj used to speak this sloka very often. Mundak Upanishad. It is written, Brahma Devanam Prathamaha Swayam Bhuva Vishyasya Karta Bhuvanasya Gupta Sa Brahma Vidam Brahma Vidvam Sa Brahma Vidvam Sarva Vidvya Pratishtam Atharvayo Jeshta Purthay Putraya Praho Jenaksharam Purusham Veda Sat Mana Satyam Pravacho Tvam Tattato Brahma Vidvam. This means, actually it is coming through parampara. Brahma receiving this, thing from Krishna. Krishna is the Chaturmukh, Hai Krishna Sevamukh, Brahma is the Naradara Madhi, Narada is the Vyas, Madhukaya Vyasunaka, Vyasudasa, Purna Pagga Paddhanapa Madhi, Nihari Madhava Angshya, Akshava Paramangshya, Sishyavari Angikara Kvare. This way, you will have to follow. Akshabhira Shishoya Tittame Puriyat Tadasa Gyanashundutare Tayate Dayanadi Tardasa Vidyanadi Rajendo Hilo Tavite Taro Kinkoraja Dharmaname Puriyaya Parampara Jano Valamate. Now coming. Come to the point. Parampara Jano Valamate. Valamate mean very good parampara. What Prabhupada wanted to mean? Parampara Jano Valamate. Kishnaita Chaturmukh. After that, Parampara Jano Bhalamati. Mean, Prabhupada wanted to indicate this is exact mantra parampara. But if there is any breakage, if there is no question of, thinking about who is Acharya, oh, Maharaj and Acharya, yes, then, successive order. A successive order, one demon can be Acharya. He liked to put one knife in front of Gurudev and want to get the post of Acharya. Who is going to check up? Maharaj, this is Kolikal, you are so foolish, don't understand. And Bhagavan Sri Krishna in front of Uddhavji Maharaj speaking, Uddhav, Bhagavan speaking in front of Uddhav, Uddhav, Kalena Nashta Pralaye Baniyam Veda Sangita, Mayado Brahmane Prakta, Dharmo Jasyam Madatmakaha. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Uddhav, actually, in course of time, the absolute truth, this parampara is just missing. Kalena nashta pralaye baniyam, veda sangita. Mayado brahmane prakta dharmo yasam madatpakaha. I at all first spoke to Brahma, and after there is different kind of, pralay, nitya pralay, naimatik pralay, prakritik pralay, different kind of pralay, So in pralay, evolution and dissolution of this nature, then it is missing. Then again I need to speak. So Krishna speaking, I am not going to speak in details, I am going to give indication. Kalena nashta pralaye baniyam, veda sangitaha. Kalena nashta pralaye baniyam veda sangita mayado brahmane prakta dharmo yasam madatmaka teno prakta saputrayo manave itadi. After that dot again a last coming, javir bhutani vidante bhutanam patayostatha evam prakriti vaichitrad vidyante matayo ninam paramparjena kesanchit pasanto matayo apare. I already explained, this way. This way, this complete flow of Amnai Dara, complete flow of Sauta Pantha, complete four of Bhagavad Dhara, Bhaktivinoda Dhara, can get lost for some being in front of you. But Bhaktivinoda Dhara can never be extinct. Always will be there. So maybe I cannot find, so I think Bhaktivinoda Dhara is no more there. Bhaktivinoda Dhara speaking, those who are acting as Acharya, it is their main duty to give protection, you know, to the Sampradaya. If they are not doing, then they are not at all Acharya. From Sajjan Tosani, 4th canto, 115 and 116 pista, pages. You know, if all wrong conception going, wrong Siddhanta, some Sahajya, in the name of Gauri Acharya, Gauri Vaishnava is doing all rubbish, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. To rectify this, you know, wrong conception, wrong Siddhanta, Dushto Matke, Shodhan Karvar Jatna Kariven, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking in Bengali. If there is any wrong conception, wrong etiquette, you must try to rectify it. If you go to do it, if in this case, if you develop some problem fighting with some, you know, cunning people, those are shoot people, very bad, in a dress of Acharya, red cloth, white cloth, and maybe Acharya, you can develop some problem with them. Still, you will have to accept it if you love Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. In the name of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I will have to accept. I am not going to enjoy popularity because I like to protect the interest of Guru Bharga. Otherwise, very easily, by song, because song is there in my blood, I can start singing this, that, I can get, and a big, massive population can come. But I hate. I don't like to do it. I like to speak state card about that absolute truth. I like to follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I like to follow Prabhupada. I like to follow Keshav Goswami, Bhaktivinoda. No way. If I'm going to die still. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur give me instruction. If there is any wrong conception, very bad conception, Siddhanta going on, you will have to rectify it. It is your, you should try. If you go to do this, if you develop some fighting with somebody, they are not going to like you, they like to throw you many times in my life. Many times in my life happened so. Anywhere I started speaking, I'm not going to give the list. If you can come, I can speak. Not in Harikatha, because I have no enmity with anybody. I have no enmity, believe me or not. If they come to me, they are all my sons, you know, or in the form of God brothers, maybe. I'm not going to speak name. All this, stop my Harikatha, you know, wanted to put me out of mud. Okay, very good. Is one kind of kripa. I never hate them, you know. But anyway, up to my last breathing, I am going to avoid those, you know, evil association. I don't like to see their face even. There is a strict instruction by Prabhupada. I don't like to see their face. I don't like to see their face at the time of my death. I don't like to see their face. Let them do what they like. I am not going to fight. But I can go on speaking in my absolute way. If somebody is going to accept it, okay. If not going to accept, still okay. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it is your duty to rectify wrong Siddhanta, wrong etiquette, everything. But we are not going to follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur. If you develop this kind of problem with maybe somebody not going to give me financial help, so what? If one rich man become angry, hey, I sick, hey, you go away. I don't need your help. Many times speak, you go away. If somebody going to put condition, na Maharaj, I am doing this, you know, I am going to give this donation for this seva, you will have to do it. I said, no, you can go back with your money. I don't like to touch your money. This kind of life is very good. Any amount coming, I should, you know, is for Gomata seva, Bani seva, translation seva. Sometime I am taking the help of somebody, but they are also making mistake in translation. They don't understand the theme, especially they don't know Bengali. I'm paying heavy amount. And I myself doing, and I'm not a language student actually, I don't know. Somehow by the mercy of Gurudev, I'm doing. You must excuse me actually. You know, anyway, Bhaktivinoda was speaking, if you are going to develop some, you know, bitterness or some problem with this kind of, then this kind of people, those who are against, you know, absolute truth, still it is okay. Because in the name of Gauranga, we will have to do everything. Bhaktivinoda was speaking, Bhaktivinoda giving advice, not even a single day, not even a single day, we cannot allow even a single day to go in vain. Bhaktivinoda was speaking, not even a single day, we cannot allow even a single day to go in vain. We will have to utilize each and every fraction of second in our life. Then we can do Hari Bhajan. You know, Hari Bhajaner, Manushya Jana, Bhaktivinoda was speaking, human body is most rare. We should not misuse even a single day, single hour, single fraction of second we cannot misuse, you know, not a matter of joke. And until and unless we are going to stand in a neutral platform, we cannot understand all this thing. And Bhaktivinoda was speaking, nobody can act as an acharya. Nobody can act as an acharya until and unless he is going to stand on a neutral platform. But who is your neutral? You can show. They can come and touch Shalagram and Nrisimhadev and speak, we are neutral. Have some party color. There's some group. They are going to protect their own lab, puja, patishtha. They are less interested about sampradaya. Huh? Useless. And Gauriya sampradaya. Who is going to think? I am going to let interested about me. I like to project myself. Bhaktivinoda was speaking, until and unless we are going to stand on a neutral platform, we cannot act as an acharya. No, nobody can act as an acharya. If he is not going to stand on neutral platform, who can stand on neutral platform? He is Mahabhagavat. Is automatically you are going to give answer, you see. Automatically you can get answer. Automatically. So we cannot allow, you know. And Bhaktivinoda is speaking, those who are going to accept Gaudiya Sampradaya to get some facility. Some Mayavadi also coming to join our Sampradaya in the guise of Sannyasi Acharyas. But their activities, I can prove totally they are Mayavadi. I am not going to give any personal Siddhanta. I can put the Siddhanta of Popan Bhaktivinoda. Bhaktivinoda is speaking, those who are going to accept externally this Gaudiya Sampradaya, externally, but going to disobey, asikar karen, is pranali, the exact way of bhajan, they are going to ignore. Oh, useless. We will have to follow the new procedure. Okay. Bhaktivinoda is speaking, jahara e pranali ki asikar karen, those who are going to disobey the procedure shown by Guru Varga, they are the greatest enemy of this sampradaya. But we are going to worship their lotus feet, we are going to get their water wash, going give garland, Chaitanya, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Charananu Charganer Pradhan Shatru, Bengali. They are the topmost, you know, enemy of this Chaitanya Charan and his sampradaya. They are the topmost, you know, enemy of this sampradaya. E amnai guru pranai, this amnai dhara, this flow of guru parampara, amnai dhara, sautabani, to protect, give protection, is the only duty of an acharya, Bhaktivinoda was speaking. Because guru parampara prapto vishuddha bani bhagavad dharma sangrakhan kariyache, Bengali. Bhaktivinoda was speaking, actually exact guru parampara, Sauta Parampara, going to give full protection to our Bhagavad Dharma. If Sampradaya we cannot protect, then how we can protect our, you know, if we cannot protect Bani Vaibhav, how we can protect this Sampradaya? How it is possible? How it is possible? This way, everything going to be lost. Nobody interested. This way, we are going to lose everything, Maharaj. In the infinity world, Gauriya Sampradaya, especially Sarasvat Gauriya Sampradaya, under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada, we are the luckiest man. But still, very bad luck. We are going to lose everything. Bhaktivinoda speaking, those who are going to get this designation, this post of Acharya, they should try to eliminate this anartha of Sampradaya. If they are going to ignore because of their own weakness, then no, I am weak. If I am going to rectify this, everybody can kick me. There's your character, your behavior, you are going to rectify us. This is the situation. Oh, let them do. So, tum bhi chup, hum bhi chup. I must maintain silence. You must do silence. Tum bhi chup, hum bhi chup, Prabhupada speaking. But Bhaktivinoda was speaking to rectify this anartha, to eliminate those anartha, is the main duty. Every Sampradaya. I know practically, I am sitting in Vyasasana, I am not speaking lie. In my own life I have seen, if that the leader of the temple watching that this Brahmachari having some ethical character, very good, a man of strict principle, then he is thinking, maybe some weak point is there in his life. They are topmost politician, you see. Practically I am speaking, in the name of Prabhupada I am speaking. I am not speaking lie. In my own life I have seen. That the boss of the temple, he is watching. This Brahmachari coming in our Madhata is very strict actually, very good. But maybe some weakness is there. So I will have to search out that weakness. Maybe he is weak in front of woman, beautiful woman. Or maybe he is weak in front of Pratishtha. Maybe weak in front of money. He is searching. If he is successful to find out a single point, he is going to apply this principle, political game with him, so that he can find fault with him. And that fault can be exposed in front of public, so automatically he becomes without any power. So then that, you know, boss can utilize that, you know, Brahmachari according to his own use, according to own desire. So great political leader there. Great, you know, very big political leader there. They want to find out, there is some weakness must be there. You know, he is not Siddha Mahatma. Let me see. If they find this kind of, they can apply this formula to make you weak. And if they are going to expose your, you know, weakness, then automatically they can use it according to them. Hey, you have to do, you cannot say no. If you are going to speak no, they can expose this in front of public. Very nice formula they are applying. Very nice. They should go away to their own home. They should go away. They are making garbage in Sampradaya. They should go away with their collected money. They can go. They live their life very nicely. They are making garbage. Doing dangerous situation, they are doing all danger for themselves and for those who are, you know, blind men. Andhayathandoirupuniyamanam, they are also going to follow him. They are also going to meet with a great danger. This is the present situation. This is the present situation. What to do? And now, you know, all different kind of, you know, explanation from different angle. Also, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, you should remember, if somebody acting as Acharya or big great sannyasis, but still if you find, have some attraction for love, puja, patishta, even smell, then it's big danger. Bhaktivinoda Thakur especially wanted to speak, you know, in this sloka, very nice sloka, from Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, 1st Canto, 17th chapter, 38 to 41 sloka. The sloka going to expose and unveil the mystery. Again, here it is, you know, everybody knowing. When Parikshit Maharaj and are going to throw Kali out of country. Then Kali crying and begging for pardon. Kali speaking, Maharaj, where to go? No place. Wherever I look, I see you are influenced here, everywhere. So please give me place. According to your rules and regulation, I can lead my life. You can give some rules and regulation. Then Prajakit Maharaj, you know, according to his application, request, so he is, you know, requesting, so abhartitos tada tasmai sthanani kalaye dadau. You know, he is requesting very, you know, heavily in front of Parikyamu Maharaj, where to go, where to go, please give me some place. I cannot make any rules and regulations, please give me. Put me in under restriction, then Parikshit Maharaj giving. Because Parikshit Maharaj is Mahabhagavat, very intelligent. He thought, though Kali is full of danger, but there is very nice quality, one quality. You know, Kalau, dosa nidhe rajan, asti ek mahan gunaha, kittanad eva krishnascha, mukta sanga param brajet. Only by Sankirtan. Only by perfect Sankirtan, you can attain success in Kalikal. This is your advantage, but you are not going to take this advantage. In future, by the mercy of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Guru Bhargo and all, if you are going to bless me, I like to apply this principle. You know, Kali cannot do anything. Sadayam hidayam yasyo vachah satva bhushitam. You know, kayah parahitam yasyo kalihitasyo karotikim. I remember now this sloka. Very nice. It is from Niti Shastra. In Sanskrit learning, there is a Niti Shastra there. You know, there. Sadayam hidayam yasyo vachah satva bhushitam sadayam hidayam yasyo vachah satva bhushitam kayah parahitam yasyo kalihitasyo karoti kim. What Kali can do with me? I can explain this sloka next day. What Kali can do with Vidurji Maharaj? From temple, you can throw out pure Vaishnava. So what it concern to them? You are going to go, you are gradually going into hell, straightway. Vidurji Maharaj, so great Vaishnava, but not in front of Duryodhana. Duryodhana like to kick him out, so it's very good. Now, this is the problem. We are opening big, big temple. We are making big, big project. Otherwise, how we can collect money? Big, big project. We have some big project to make full of people, this project. After that, we are making more temple, society, everything. But we are going to throw out pure Guru Vaishnava outside temple. We like to kill them. We like to throw them out so that nobody can see whatever, you know, all nonsense I am doing. There is a present formula. Very nice. So you are going to throw pure Guru Vaishnava out of... But anyway, you can test. If that Vaishnava is going to sit in a forest, still there he can make a nice preaching. And whereas you cannot do preaching. How you can do preaching? Anywhere, if there is no room, no place, in a open field, you can allow him sit, he can go on doing. Like Bhakti, Vivek Bharati Maharaj, open field, no mic, nothing, in Dhaka, before making Dhaka temple. Speaking Harikatha, there was big competition. But I never tried to do any competition with anybody. I never tried to do any competition with anybody regarding Harikatha, Kirtan. Never, never. It is not a matter of competition. It is a matter of realization. If by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava I can realize, I can do. I can explain this show. What is dangerous for Vidurji Maharaj? Those who are pure Vaishnava, what Kali can do? What harm can Kali can do to them? Sadayam hidayam yasyo bachaho satya bhushitam. Bachaho, whereas he is always speaking about their absolute truth. Bachaho satya bhushitam. Kayaha, his body is all for you. My body is all for you. I am dancing according to your desire. That's why I am speaking Harika. If I am going to follow my mind, whimsical mind, then I cannot speak Harikatha. Follow. Kayaha parahitam yasyaha kalihi tasya karoti kim. What Kali can make danger in his life? Nothing. Because his target is only to do Hari Bhajan. You can kick him out of temple, he can go away. But you see, how many kicks I was bound to accept. How many kicks I was bound to accept. But ultimately, I was thinking over and again, maybe this is a good, you know, a kripa of Supreme Lord. 100% I was thinking, maybe, I will have to wait and see. What is the target of? If I break down, then I cannot carry out the order of Nityananda. I cannot carry out the order of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I cannot carry out the order of Prabhupada and Guru Bhargava. So I'll have to keep patience. Keep patience. You know, if I am going to lose my patience, then I cannot speak Harikatha. It's not possible to understand, realize Harikatha. So, I can discuss this point. In the life of an Acharya, there should not be any smell of these things. Because I can explain, and first I can speak this sloka, after that I can explain. Abharthitos tada tasmai sthanani kale dadau dutam panam sriyaha shuna yatra dharmo chaturvidaha. And punascha jachamanayo jato rupam adat prabhu, you know, tato anritam madam kamam rajo bairancha panchamam. After that it is written, Amuni panchasthanani hi adharma prabhavaha kalihi uttarena dachyani navasat tat nideshakit. Amuni, those are the place where Kali was allowed to stay. Amuni pancho mane five. Amuni panchasthanani hi adharma prabhavah kalihi uttarena datyani and navasat tan nideshakit. After that, the vital point speaking. Athaitani na seveto bhubusha purusha pachit. That is why, Sukhdev Goswami speaking. Athaitani na seveto bhubushaha purushaha kvachit visheshato dharma silo raja loko po loko patir guruha. Now, out of this description of Bhagavatam, I can go on discussing what is the symptom of Bhajan. You can just go mad. You know, I like to open your eyes. No question of fighting. I can go on explaining. Next day, 11th, I can try to discuss. But today, I cannot discuss. Time is over. I will have to go for some other seva. Kipaya hori kirtana murti dharam dharani varahar kagaura janam janakadika vasala singhda padam pranamami sada prabhupada 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 padam vancha kalpadurvasya kepasindu bevacha patitanang pavana bhavishna bhyo namo.